Runa Madimoa, Runa
Tepala,
loves us. He has given us our mouths to praise Him. He has given us our hands to clap in praising and worshiping
Thank
Him.
Jesus.
Can we please just join in this morning as we sing this one more song in honor and in reverence of the Holy Spirit that is in this place this morning.
Hallelujah.
We might not think or seem like it is here, but
Hallelujah.
The Lord is here in this place. There is no any other time and other place where He is this morning than here.
Amen.
So let us lift up His holy name and say He is holy.
Hallelujah.
He is Jehovah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Imrebebe kesa kala baba kasiende ungu Jehovah pila ungu Jehovah namusa siyambona every morning and every night, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Even this morning onkulunkulu namandla sikhothama phambi kobuso bakho. We come before the throne of grace even this morning, oh God. We say You are holy. We lift up Your holy name. We lift up our praises to You in the name of Jesus. Abakasekerebebekesia. We even say this morning, oh God, join me as I say, He is Lord. Yes, He is Lord.
He is Lord.
Lord,
yes,
He is Lord.
Oh,
He has
even this morning, we lift up our hands in praises to you, O Jehovah. We say we bless you, O Jehovah. You are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords. Thank you, Jehovah. We glorify your holy name, O God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us continue to bring praises to him. How many of us know the songs which says Kabarendwe? Hallelujah. Let us all just see Sihlabelele bazalwane. This morning, can we just remember, we praise, we're bringing praises to the King. We're saying we're praising the Lord, Linda. That is what Sihlabelela means. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Kabarendwe.
Of God is in this place, amen. Ooh, hallelujah.
I'm assuming myself a little bit so that I can do good on television. Hallelujah. Let me bring my other eyes so that I can see all the beautiful people in the house.
Hallelujah. Good morning, Kingdom Community.
Wow. Welcome to KCSA. We transform followers into leaders and leaders into agents of change. That's why we exist. This is why we wake up every morning. This is what fills us. This is what propels us forward. Amen. This morning, for those of you who've joined us in the middle of the briefing session, my name is Kwena Siema. It is such an honor for me to be here this morning. It is such an honor for me to welcome you this morning. I'd like to remind all of you that our senior ambassador, Ambassador Charlie Masala, is on a diplomatic mission. He's on a diplomatic mission which has taken him to the Cape. So he's in Cape Town this morning, ministering there. Amen. Just getting my tools ready here. Right. So the first thing I'd like to do is, of course, as I've said, I'm a senior ambassador is out in Cape Town this morning. He's ministering actually right now, providing instructions from the King. To the diplomats in Cape Town. So for us diplomats here, we are in for a treat. For those of you who are joining us online, hallelujah, you are in for a treat this morning. You're gonna be happy you joined. So amen, amen. So the first thing I wanna do is I wanna welcome everyone who's visiting us for the very first time here at the community. We want to give you a royal welcome. So if you can indicate where you are this morning, if you're joining us for the very first time, by raising of your hand, welcome, sir. Welcome, family. So we'll give you a current. Amen. 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 Right. Welcome to KCSA Briefing. It's the right place to be. Amen. I also want to welcome to all our ambassadors that are joining us in other GPS coordinates that are known to us, which are Bloemfontein, the family in Bloemfontein, we welcome you. In Namibia, Ambassador Martin, we can't wait to be with you in person. We welcome you as well. And our family in Newcastle, we also welcome you guys. It's such a great thing to see you so faithful with us every week. We welcome you and thank you for being with us this morning. I would have you know that our meetings generally will continue in this hall every week. The next week, Sunday, it is our last in-person service for this year, for this calendar year, okay? For this calendar year, 2021, our final in-person session will take place in this very hall. It's called Mahogany Hall here. At a new hotel, that will be next week Sunday. After that, we will be online until in the new year. Amen. So, if you are new and you want to join us next week, please be here with us next week. Also, what are you gonna do next week? Because it is our last one this year in person. We are gonna have a feast, right? So after the session, we will all go to the embassy. To go have a feast at the embassy. That's what diplomats do, right? They go to embassies. So for those who are a little slow, embassy, it will be the Masala home. that's where we'll be after the service, and we will then have a feast there. Okay. Our Kingdom Youth Services. How many of you have been watching our Kingdom Youth Services? I mean, it's empowering. Amen. So our Kingdom Youth Services will continue every Friday at 7 o'clock. We are very innovative. You can count on that because we have the Spirit of God. Amen. The Spirit of God is not boring. So you can count on Him being very innovative. That's why every week you'll always see something new that we are doing. So please join us with the youth and bring your young ones. They will be blessed. Amen. We will be having hallelujah. Amen, amen. We will be having a royal. I'm excited already myself. We'll be having a royal birth encounter, a play. Hallelujah. Yes. I promise you, you don't want to miss this one. I was in the rehearsals yesterday for the play. Hallelujah. It was right. So you want to be there. Amen. So that will take place on the 11th, Saturday the 11th, at Roy Hescral Terrain or Historical Terrain. It's right here in Centurion. We will have a play there staged from 1800 hours or 6 o'clock on that Saturday. And we will have a cast mostly coming from the people you see in here and some that you haven't met yet. And we'll have Kindi also ministering there. Amen. Kindi music. For those of you who were at Women's Convention, you have met Kindi and you've seen his music. Powerful, powerful minister. And of course, we'll have our own team. Don't worry, they have been trained. They will do Christmas carols on the day. Amen. So it's going to be a day of celebration as we remind people for the reason for the season. Right? It's not an Xmas season. It's a Christmas. Mass means celebration. We are celebrating Christ. Christ means the anointed king, the Messiah. So this is a season for the celebration of the anointed king. So we are here to remind everyone that there is a reason for the season. Amen. So we will be having that royal birth encounter and the Christmas carols. Please join us. The cost for the adults, it will be 250 rands per adult. And for each adult, 2 kids can come for free. All right? In terms of the age of the kids, you decide. Just the first 2 kids that you decide they are kids. Amen. 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 So you have the Spirit of God in you, and God is not a liar. Amen. Amen. So, with that, and then from the third kid up, we will ask for 100 rand. We are paying for the venue. Each and every person who comes in, we are paying for that person who comes through the gates. Amen. And we'll make sure, don't worry, you won't be hungry. Ambassador Pumzile has been working very hard to make sure that there are some refreshments there as well. And you can be well looked after. Hallelujah. Amen. We will also then follow that. So that is the royal birth encounter, right? Then during Christmas, so the 24th and the 25th, which is Christmas period, we will then play what we would have called a Christmas conference, right? So you will see something very different on our platforms. That will all be online. So I encourage you to watch out, watch the space, and watch what we will be doing online during Christmas. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's move it on. And on the 7th to the 10th of July 2022, something is coming. Touch somebody and say, something is coming. You really don't want to miss this one. It will be our first Kingdom Leadership Summit. Amen. I can promise you, I have had a meeting with the ambassador. I have had a meeting with the senior ambassador. I have seen what is coming. So when I make a promise, it's not a promise of faith. I'm not hoping. I can tell you, I've seen the plan. Amen. You don't want to miss this one. It is from the 7th to the 10th. So prepare for it. If you're running your own business, you've got to prepare your people that you are unavailable from the 7th to the 10th. If you have to ask for leave, you've got to prepare them bosses that we are unavailable from the 7th to the 10th. Amen. The earlier we do it, usually the better. Amen. So it's going to be great. And then on that Sunday, we're going to celebrate our 1 year anniversary. It's going to be a celebration. So please make sure you are ready and you are there. You don't want to miss out and say, I wish I was there. All right. And at this time, what I'd like to also remind you is that we have some product table out there on the table. You'll find a beautiful ambassador there.
Ambassador my one. Amen. So, friends, ambassadors, diplomats, knowledge is key. If you're going into a diplomatic mission without knowledge, you remember what happened to these guys who wanted to cast a demon out. And then the demon said, Jesus I know, Paul I know, who are you guys? You don't want to be found wanting. The Bible says, study to show yourself faithful, right? It says you want to be a servant who is rightly dividing the word of truth. So we need to study. So don't just walk past knowledge, because it doesn't come by osmosis. It takes us actually getting in it, studying, learning, and asking God to help us apply that knowledge so that we can have wisdom in our lives. Amen. Amen. So please do pass by there. Get some knowledge, and God will help us grow together. Amen. At this time, I'd like to invite Ambassador Linda, as he's going to lead us in kingdom taxes and investments. Amen.
Good day, everyone. Even though our ambassador is not here today, we have a guest speaker, and I would like to say that I met our guest speaker, Professor Zondi, a couple of years ago, and he climbed into my heart because he was so humble to help me come to terms with the death of my little cat. And it might seem very trivial to everybody that my cat was so important to me, but having no children and having my husband pass away, my cats were my companions. And when I lost my cat, I was devastated. But Ambassador Charlie and Professor Zondi and both families came to my home. They validated me and they gave me a funeral. So, Professor Zondi, you are forever in my heart. You are not only a professor, but you're very, very humble, and you serve God very well. Thank you. Thank you. And we'd like to say, Ambassador Charlie, we missed you, but we know that you're making your mark wherever you go. And we feel the presence of God here today, and we are so grateful for the rain. And as we sang today, yes, the presence of God is absolutely present with us, and it's vibrant, and it's exciting, and it's so beautiful for me to see how we are growing in this community. Today, my motivation for you comes from Matthew 6, verse 1 to 4, where it says, we must give in secret. I also need my eyes. My second set of eyes. Giving in secret. Take care. Don't do your good deeds publicly to be admired, because then you will lose the reward from your Father in heaven. When you give a gift to someone in need, don't shout about it as the hypocrites do, blowing their trumpets in the synagogues and streets to call attention to the acts of charity. But Jesus says, but when you give to someone, don't tell your left hand what your right hand is doing. Give your gifts in secret, and your Father, who knows all about you, will reward you. I want to say that our giving is all about our act of love towards God. We are so blessed. And today when Ambassador Quena said, we've got our hands, we've got our feet, we've got our mouths, we do not realize actually that we are blessed beyond. But so often our motives aren't always pure. And when they were talking about the hypocrites, So often people want to boast about their good deeds. But Jesus says, if you are going to boast about everything that you are doing, that is your only reward that you are going to get. Jesus wants us to give in secret. And that, when we give in secret, we are asking, are we trying to please God, or are we trying to please man and ourselves? Because when we benefit for ourselves, we are not really honoring God. And now what I'd like to say is the word ego, when we give so that the people can notice us, we are boasting, and our egos are big. But I've got an acronym for the word ego. Ego, E stands edging, the G, God, and the O, out. So when we have our huge egos, we are edging God out of our lives. So may we always, yeah, as kingdom citizens and ambassadors and diplomats, always put God first. And do as he says, give in secret. Don't boast about what you're doing, because that is the only reward we're going to get. And we are actually seeking our eternal reward from God. Heavenly Father, thank you that this community is growing in leaps and bounds. Thank you for all these wonderful people that are here today. And as they are preparing their hearts to give, may their motives not be like the hypocrites. The hypocrites, their motives are hollow. Their deeds are good, but their motives are all about themselves. May our motives, Lord, be about bringing you joy, pleasing you, honoring you, and knowing that by our giving, it is such a joy. And Lord, you know that as I'm studying the scriptures about giving, I think that it is one of the most wonderful things that we are able to do is to give. Because if we do not give with a good heart, we are actually depriving ourselves. Thank you, Lord, that you are blessing this community. And may we today give unselfishly and cheerfully. In Jesus' name, amen.
Intentional, never failing. I know that all things are working for my good. Yeah, she's intentional, never failing. All things are
working for my good.
'Cause she's intentional.
She's intentional.
Hey, and it's never failing. All things are working for
my good.
He's intentional.
He's intentional.
Never failing.
Never failing.
All things are working.
Hey,
all things are working for my good. Yes, they are. All things are working for my good.
Cause
he's intentional.
He's intentional.
America. It's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me. Yeah, I believe it's working for me. I can smile again and I don't have to worry, cause it's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me. Yeah, it's working for me. Come on, sing that out, say that.
I don't have to worry,
cause it's working for me. Yeah.
Working for me.
It's working for me. I can hold my head up.
It's working
hey,
for me.
Get your confidence back. Six, I don't have to worry.
It's working for me.
My faith is rising now.
It's working for me.
And although I can't see how,
it's working for me.
I know that he's intentional.
Oh, yeah. It's working for me and it's working for my good. Hallelujah. And I believe it's working for you too. Praise the Lord. If you don't believe it, Mina, I believe it. It's working for my good and working for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We are so excited. We are so humbled today to have Onondaba. Ngesivenda sithi borikanda bomsanda. Ozondi. Hallelujah. I just spoke in tongues there. Hallelujah. Rokandiwa namusi ngabomsanda bozondi. My mom would say siphe mandla, which simply means give us the power, amandla. Yes. Similar to his name, which is Sipha Amandla, he gives it. Mama uthi, give us, but his Pamanda says, we give it. It's the same, Bazalwane. Hallelujah. Very close to our family, to our hearts. Bab Zondi, thank you so much for honoring the community this morning and come and be with us when Usine Ambassador is not here today. But Ngulungulu has given your name to him, and we know that he has something for us today to learn as the community, to learn as the citizens of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. We cannot wait to hear from you. He is one of the lecturers at the University of Johannesburg. He is married to one wife, beautiful wife, and two daughters. They are somewhere here in the house. Like Linda was sharing the story of how honorable and how humble Babu Zondi is. That is the truth that we know. That is the truth that we witness as well, as the community, as the family, and as the people that have known Babu Zondi all these years. Hallelujah. I also bring greetings to my husband from Cape Town. He's teaching this morning at Hope of All Nations in Cape Town, Western Cape. He has already started teaching. They started at 9 o'clock. He's going to be teaching on the redefining the ecclesia. The ecclesia. Right. That one. Yes. Amen. Yes, some of these words are crafted and created for those that need to be teaching the word. Tina, we are supposed to introduce them. Just need to know it for that moment. Hallelujah. I just like to also to honor the Poganes who are here today with us. Thank you so much, Ambassador Lego and Ambassador Seed, for coming in today and just being with us. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. I'd also like to honor and welcome Ambassador Mbali for coming today and being with us. She does the flowers. She didn't bring them today, but she does them. Yes. Her and Mam Zondi do. The Poganes do, if they are in business, they do a hygiene cleaning. So those hygiene things that you've seen in my house, reading my CD, they are there.
the engines behind it. So let us support Black business, Wambali, my CB business is here. We also like to welcome Ambassador Kapari, who's here with us today. He is one of the senior citizens with us today. Thank you so much. We welcome you, sir. I'm going to tell my husband that you were here. We honor you and we appreciate you for coming today. Thank you, and he's one of the elders and the senior persons in the community and in this in the nation of South Africa. Amen. Hallelujah. So I would like for us to stand. Who did I forget? Nobody. Ambassador Tandi, thank you so much for coming this morning as well. You're always here with us. God bless the Lord. And I would like to Professor Babzondi to come forward as they fix his microphone, please. Hallelujah. Amen.
Oh, oh, oh.
Jesus Christ. I like to greet those who are called the ambassadors of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I like to greet those who are not just followers, but are mandated representatives. Hallelujah. I greet those who know what makes them different, regardless of circumstances. I greet those because of what they know. They walk according to what they know a lot more than according to what they see. Hallelujah. I greet those who know themselves before they are told by circumstances what they might be. I greet those who know that they will leave and be abandoned before Corona hits them. I just want to greet those that the Lord says have been blessed abundantly, even if it is financially difficult for now. I want to teach those who understand what David means when he says, though I go through the valley of the shadow, not of death, of the shadow of, not of death, but of what looks like it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's when I greet those that God says they are fearfully and wonderfully made. Whatever someone else thinks about your hairstyle or what they think about your walk, how you are built and stuff, but you are wonderfully and fearfully made. Can I repeat it? It doesn't say only wonderfully, which is what we see, but fearfully. In other words, carefully, thoughtfully, meditatively made. Hallelujah. It is great to be in the company of ambassadors because we become who we hang out with. I am great, but I became greater in your company. I don't know what you think of yourself, but I do know I've just lifted my standard by being in your presence. You may look down upon yourself. You may look at yourself familiarly, thinking you are what you are. But because I've come into your presence and understand what God made with you, I feel I have promoted myself. So that is why when I greet you, I'm so humbled, knowing that I'm greeting the great among the great. Let me say again, you are great. Let me say again, you are great. Even if we called you a human being, you would still be great because of everything God created, the last thing God made. Of everything created, the one thing made was a human being. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everything was made once, and the only thing made twice was you and I. Hallelujah. Yes. For those who have mothers and around this time, December, we remember our mothers, you know, around this time. Because, you know, mothers, you know, love us so much that they would wake us up at 4 when it is holidays to clean the house that was cleaned yesterday. You know what it means. When it has been cleaned twice, it's another level of cleaning. Hallelujah. We were made twice. Everything else was made once. An inner man was made in Genesis 1:26. And then an outer man was made in Genesis 2 verse 8. So you were made twice. So I am thinking that if something attacks the second man, the first man will rise. Many things attack this second man that you can see. Many things attack it. Huh? Sickness and disease. See what I mean? The thing like that, accident, stuff. Situation, fatigue, whatever it is, can attack this man. But I have a second man. I have a spare wheel. I have a spare wheel. Those who drive a car with a spare wheel will not sleep on the road. Can I say it again? Those who drive a car that has a spare wheel will not sleep on the road. Those who are made humans will not perish. Because one thing will perish, another will proceed. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But that is a greeting. Thank you very much. I come from a world where when you greet, you describe who people are so that you are clear to yourself who you are greeting. Because they might, in the passage of time, because of situations, forgot who they were. Hallelujah. It might be that in the passage of time, you remember what you could do, but you forgot who you were. Both good and bad times can cause us to forget who we are, but our victory is in who we are more than other things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know that the things you have will perish? Can perish today. And you know that the things you've acquired, the image and everything else can perish. But you will never perish. Because it's been promised not that our things won't perish, but we will not perish. It is the word of God that says the world will pass away. The heavens will also pass away. But they who trust in the Lord shall last forever. So I am so humbled to stand in the midst of people that the Lord says will outlast life itself, will outlast circumstances themselves. So even those who are watching by television, I just want to remind you that you are not ordinary, that you are not just a human being living among others, but you are great, you are awesome, you have the capability, regardless of what you are going through now, good or bad, you are greater than any circumstance. And the best is yet to come. Hallelujah. So we are very humbled, me and my wife and my kids, who are my bosses, and my wife's mother-in-law, Mbali, and my wife's high school mate, and the guy who came, who followed her to the airport and proposed there at the airport, the guy from Mpumalanga. Where did Dimabuza comes from? And then and our dear sister, Utabi, who takes my wife out to the bush. They call it their hiking. But they never do this thing, but they go into the bush. I always pray for my wife to be safe in those bushes, but it's fine. I just want to greet you all. Thank you so much, Ambassador Koli and Charlie, in his absence. And we know that his spirit is present with us here. Thank you very much, my dear sister. We love you so much. Always dear in our hearts. And our kids love you more than we love you. Yeah, so it is fun. So you can take your seat, Bazalwana. Or before you take your seat, Bazalwana, there's something I would like us to start with very quickly in this age. In the book of Psalm 5, verse number 3, in the book of Psalms 5, today is the 5th of the month. It says in the morning in the NIV, "In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I lay my request before you." And then it says, "And I wait patiently." Then in the 12th verse, it says, "Surely, Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with a favor as a shield." So I want you to say after me, "Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the morning, I lay my requests. I lay my issues. I lay my fears. I lay my worries. I lay my sickness. I lay, oh God, my concerns. I lay my wishes, my needs, my wants, my dreams, my visions, my plans before you. And I wait patiently, for I know you are faithful enough to do the very thing you had me say. It is you who promised that you will do what I say. I only have to say and wait and expect from you that you will do the very thing I said. For Lord, we know you are our refuge. We can trust upon you. We can depend on you to do great and mighty things that no man can understand. So right now, God, I declare that my blessings have come into my first man, the inner man. In due time, they will manifest in my outer man. I will receive that which I wished before you. In Jesus' name, I declare I will not live under limitations, under any shortage, any form of lack of any kind. In Jesus' name, I declare I am rich beyond measure. I live in abundance. I live without limitation, because you, God, have made me so. I declare that any form of disturbance, any form of stumbling block, any form of limitation that seeks to attack me, it is annullified. Right now, I melt every mountain on my way. I level the ground I walk on. Oh, Father, I declare my foot is firm and strong to tread on without any limitation. So I am confident. I am strong. I have self-belief. I know I will do greater things than the Lord Jesus was able to do. So all who come near me are blessed, because they have come into encounter with power itself. I shall speak life in them. It will manifest. I shall speak breakthroughs upon their life. They will manifest, because I know I have what you have given me, the power and the mandate to have dominion over everything that creepeth on the ground, flies in the air, and creeps underground, because I have power that comes from the divine. Come on, celebrate. Let Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you. Your people are blessed. Your people have declared it. I pray that you'll deliver the very thing they said. You'll make sure that they succeed in Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. You can take a seat kindly. I apologize, especially for those who are wearing heels, high heels, for keeping them standing longer than they should. It's fine. You girls there at the back, you have your flat shoes and your sneakers. You can stand as long as these friends here are standing. Hallelujah. So this morning, I would like us to talk about the king commanded, look and see. I would like to entitle the message, look, see. Hallelujah. Can you say to your neighbor, look? And pause a bit, pause a bit. And then say, see. Amen. Say again, look. See. Hallelujah. Barcelona, you know that looking and seeing is not the same thing. You know that looking and seeing is not the same thing. You know, Barcelona, that you can look and not see. And you know that you can see what we're not looking for. Hallelujah. You know that you can look and not see what you want to see. And perhaps see what you never wanted to see. But you know that you can see what you never looked for. Hallelujah. Or never looked at. Hallelujah. And that's the ability God has given us, the ability to look and the ability to see. And as kingdom leaders, one of our biggest challenges is forgetting to look, and it's also forgetting to see. As a result, we say what we are not looking for, and we say what we are not seeing. And as a result, we don't receive what we are supposed to receive because we looked, we said what we're not looking, or said what we're not seeing. Or we looked and saw in reverse. Hallelujah. Now, we're going to use the scripture to help us do that. It's in the book of Daniel. Daniel was the prophet of God who saw something. I would like us to go into the book of Daniel 3, verse number 24 and 25. Now, in the book of Daniel, verse number 22 to 25, we get an interesting story there that I would like us to have a conversation about. We're having a conversation, Bazalwana, isn't it? So you can stop me, you can respond, you can disagree. It's okay. I'm a teacher. I'm used to disagreements. So let's have a conversation. What is the Lord saying to us? In this book, I'm reading from the NIV. It says, the king's command was so urgent and the furnace so hot that the flames of fire killed the soldiers who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You know the story. The king's command was so strong and the fire so fierce that it burned the wrong people. The king's command was so strong and the result so fierce that it killed the people who've been sent on the wrong mission. I pray that God will give that boldness for your command to be so strong and the fire coming off with so fierce that it kills the people who did not know were planning against it. It kills the plans you did not even see. That it nullifies the things that are coming to you in the wrong direction. Do you hear me? I pray that your courage in the command will be so strong that it will resolve the issues you did not even know they were coming. You understand me? Because there are things we fight with knowing. There are things we fight with and they have not yet been shown to us. But the Bible tells us that the king's command, who is the king? The king's command. And who is the king? We started by saying, who are you? Who is the king? Hallelujah. Who is the king? Who is the king? The Bible says the king's command was so strong, and the fire, which is the impact of the command. Remember, the command was to start the fire. The command is strong, and the result of it is the fire. Your word is a command. The result of it is the fire. Always has been. It's in the word of God. You speak fire with your words. It's so strong that it burned the people who were busy plotting to put you in the fire. Hallelujah. It burned the people who were plotting to put you in the fire of being fired at work. It burned the people who were plotting to destroy your business, to destroy your path, to destroy your marriage, destroy your life. It burned them because you made a command. Now, what that tells me, if you don't make a command, there are things that won't be burned, and they will end up burning you. Hallelujah. 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 I don't have to know. I don't have to have seen it. I just need to pick a command, and the word of my command will solve the things I don't even see. Yes. You understand what I'm saying? Even the king did not know that his command was going to burn the soldier. He thought his command would just only light the fire. That's all you and I need to know. My word can light the fire. What it will burn is not my business. You understand what I'm saying? Kings operate on the basis of their responsibility, not on the basis of their traditions or of the normal conditions of their life. Kings are a people of domain, and therefore they speak related to their responsibility, not because of anything else. So all the king needs to do is to command. Is to command prosperity. Is to command peace. Is to command joy. You don't have to know whether your friend has no joy. You just command the joy, just in case they will need it in 10 years' time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So when I say be rich, I'm not saying you are poor. I'm simply saying be rich. My responsibility is not to judge where you are. My responsibility is to judge where you are going. Because command is about where you are going and not where you are. I can't command you about where you are. I can command you about where you should be. Where I wish you to be. Now the Bible says the command was so strong and the fire so fierce that the soldiers sent to destroy Shadrach, Abednego, and Meshach got burned. That's another second point then for me. The fire of your command will be so strong that people who are sent to destroy you will be weakened. Forces, because the Bible tells us that we are not fighting only each other against human beings. Sometimes they don't control themselves, but we are fighting against principalities in the heavenly realm. Your command will be so strong that it will nullify the plans against you in the atmosphere. So I want to say to your neighbor, you don't have to know. Just command. Can you have a habit at every opportunity that you find, simply command, even if it is just one word, command. Please command. Say them this, say neighbor. The only reason you must command is because it is your responsibility. It's your duty to command. Hallelujah. For the Bible tells us in the first book of Peter 2 verse 9 that we are a royal priesthood, a chosen people, a holy nation. It says we are that. Now, when you are told you are a fridge. If you are told you are a fridge, to freeze meat is not an option. It's your duty. If you are told you are an eagle, to fly high, it's not even a burden, a difficulty. It's simply your nature. Now, the Bible says you are a royal priesthood. What do royals do out of nature, not out of burden? Just do that. The blessing is in knowing who I am and operating in who I am. The rest comes into its own place. For the Bible says in the book of Matthew, all things, it says all things work together to those who are called. What is to call? It's to name you. If I say you're a great business person, I'm calling you. And to call you is not to make you. God made you. It is to name you. Hallelujah. God made you. I name you. God, prophets of God name people, which is to remind them what they were made. Because the name names the things that exist. A mother gives birth to a child, and a person names a child and doesn't make the child and simply identifies the child. So those who are called according to his purpose. You are called according to God's purpose, and that purpose is not just an option. It is something that you live in. You are called according to the purpose. That's very important. Then in verse number 23, it says, and these three men, firmly tied, fell into the blazing furnace. The evil plan still happens. We said the word was so strong that it burned the people who were throwing the men into the fire. After it had burned those, the evil plan of this king, which is to throw these people who are found guilty for nothing into the furnace, still happens. Because that's how God operates. Sometimes he will allow me to go through the valley or the valley of the shadow of death. Because it's part of the plan. Because I cannot victory over, I victory through a war. To be a triumphant, I need to be in something of a contestation. So those who don't want to win a prize better not play the game. And playing the game can be painful. The playing the game gonna hurt. We victory through. So the Lord allows Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to fall into the furnace. How? And he's already said the king's command was so strong that it had burned the enemy, but still allowed the person to go in. Let's hear that. Verse number 24. Then King Nebuchadnezzar leaped to his feet in amazement. The king leapt to his feet in amazement. It says to me, he was seated down, relaxed, seeing his plan come to pass. Then at some point, he leaps to his feet in amazement. I just want to say, there's going to be a time when people relax seeing you going down. And there's going to be a split of a moment where they will leap in amazement. Can you say, Heavenly Father, may my enemies in the heavenly realm leap to their amazement at the massive turnaround in my life. May they leap in amazement at the turnaround in my life. May your turnaround cause your enemy to leap in amazement. It must be so sudden and so big and so evident that they will forget composure. They will lose their composure. And they'll be like, hey, it's you. Did you make it? Really? Oh, I celebrate you. Oh, well done. No. They are amazed. They are amazed. They will celebrate with you in amazement of what the Lord has done. It says he leapt to his feet in amazement and then he asked. He asked his advisors, when the three men that were tied up and threw into the fire. What's the problem now? It's obvious. They replied, "Certainly, Your Majesty." He said, "Look!" There's an exclamation mark. Said, "Look!" Can you say to your neighbor, "Look!" We usually say that when there is something approaching that a person might be surprised by. Good or bad. I like it when it is good. Look! Look! A bunch of flower from one body. Look! A consignment of hygiene stuff. With those nice little juices and water written king something. Yeah. Look! 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 Can you say it to your neighbor? Look! You are not surprising them. You're supposed to be such that they need to go. Look! 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 The king, normally composed, confirmed in his authority, suddenly is shocking people, causing them to look. Hallelujah. So we need people in life who are going to say, look. Do you have people in your life who say, look? Change your composure. Are there people who change your composure and complacency in a position you are in and a direction you are going to cause you to look? There is another opportunity just on the other side. There's another opportunity just right behind you. There's another opportunity just under your eyes. There's another opportunity in your midst. There's another opportunity that requires just one step more. There's another opportunity that requires that one push more. A little more push. A little more push. A little more push. One more step is lending you to an abundance. We have people who say, look. Look, 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 look. There's no time to say, perhaps if you have an opportunity, can you please look? No, because in the talking long, the opportunity might pass. You say, look. You will explain later why you shock me. I'm also shocked by what I see coming your way. I have no opportunity to phrase the proper sentence because of what I see. He says, look. Because the point I want to make, the people who tell you look are people who see. The people who tell me look can only be people who see. Hallelujah. Just check. Do you have people around you who see? Because great leaders are those who walk with the seers, not with the blind. They don't lead the blind, they lead others who also see, so that the seeing and the seeing lead to the seeing more. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the leader's duty always is to others, keep looking. Because the circumstances of life can blind us. Blessing can blind us. The last success can blind us. That the circumstances and the challenges of life can blind us to what we can actually see if we intently look. Because looking can only be done intentionally. It cannot be done unintentionally. To look, I need to turn my head. To look, I need to quench my eye. To look at it, focus my eyes. It can only be done intently. That is why it is done when it's not done intently. It is done at an instruction of someone with authority. So you and I have a duty to one another. If I will not provide you food, if I will not provide you a network, if I will not give you money, at least I must cause you to see that which will keep you sleepless at night. Excited, not stressed, about what is possible. We come into these meetings because we need to refresh each other's ability to look. Hallelujah. Then the king continues. He says, look, I see. That's powerful. The people who tell others to look, they say look because they see. He says, look, I see. I don't say look so that you see and I don't see. I say look because I see. I want you to confirm what I see, lest what I see is not for me alone, it's also for you. He says, I see four men walking around in the fire, unbound, unharmed. And the fourth looks like a son of the gods. Hallelujah. So much is this guy has seen. He sees the captives free. Hallelujah. What do you see when you go see your relative in hospital? Do you see the sick sick? Or do you see the sick free? I did not say what is the fact on the bed. But what do you see? Because what I see is what I intend seeing. It's not necessarily what is out there. Because what is actually history. What is actually history. Because what I get to read it is what became when I got there. But what I need to see is what is there going forward. Hallelujah. Look, I see four men unbound, unchained, unchained, unchained. Look, oh God, I sit in this room. I see a couple of people unchained. Unchained by worries, unchained by anxiety, unchained by ignorance. Unchained, unchained. I see people here unchained by lack. They are unchained right now by shortage of any kind. They are unchained by sickness and disease. They are unchained by dangers and accidents. They are unchained. Look, I see people here who are unchained by low self-confidence. I see people who are unchained. They are unchained, oh God. I see them here. Look, I see unchained people. Look, look. Look, guys, look, look. I see people who are unchained. Look. I see people who are unperturbed. Look, look, look. Look at that guy. Look, look, look at that Bible. Hey, boo. I see Mr. Mix. I see. Look, I see millionaires. I see, look. I see somebody whose money was held up by second. It was passage of time. I see. It's unchained. I see that promotion, that job. I see it's unchained. I see that breakthrough, that new power, that new... It's unchained. Haibo, that new oath, that new courage, that power, that strength, it's unchained. I see it. Yeah. Can you see? I see unchained people. Can you and I, because you are kingdom citizens, because you are ambassadors, never see chained people, but see unchained people who are temporarily chained? Remember, your word and your command is so strong, and the fire coming from it so fierce that whatever you see and say will be. They are unchained, you think? I see them unchained and I say they're unchained. My command is so strong because I'm so confident of what I see. And the fire so fierce that it will break the chains. It breaks every chain. There is power. There is power Oh, Jesus. You understand that? And it's also good to see additional. It's also good, it's good to see that liberty, to see that change circumstances. But it's always good to see addition. It's always good to see growth. It's always good to see an extra. The king saw a fourth man among the four, three. And the king saw what looked like the sons of God. May it be that when we see people, however bad they are, that we see the sons of God in them. May our spiritual eyes of understanding be so open that we see the fourth man in our troubled kid. That we see the fourth man in our troubled neighbor. That we see, many of you have seen neighbors that are terribly troubled, especially in the past 2 months. That may you see the fourth man in their life and speak and go there and speak it and say, I know you lost a sister. I know you lost a mother. I know you lost a situation. But I see a fourth man. And I see you unchanged. I see you unchanged by money. I see you unchanged by the circumstances. But I also see the fourth man. I see the fourth man in your life. Because I see the fourth man, whatever the fourth man tends to bring, I also already see it. The blessing, the increase, the expansion, the multiplication. May we learn, because we are kingdom citizens and we are kingdom leaders, we are leaders and ambassadors. May we learn to look, to see, and to say what we looked and saw. Hallelujah. I think there's a reason why God commands us this morning to look. It's not that we are not looking. There is a looking, and then there is a looking. I can look at you and say your hairstyle is ugly. And then I can look at you and say the hairstyle is actually nice. So man, there is a looking and then a looking. There is a look and there is a look. There is a look and there is a look. God wants us to lose the first look. That's why I told look. So that we will see anew. Then we will say anew. Because many of us do say what we look at instead of what we look at. It's reality. Eh? Hallelujah. He said, I see four men unbound. So the point I wanted to make is that as kings, we look and we see. That's very important for me. And we say. That's very important for me. Now, if we simplify it, kings issue decree. May you, before you beg and wonder what it is, can you just decree on your friends? Sometimes they come to you because God knows, God thinks you know who you are, so you won't just ruminate in their rumor, in their gossip, in their worries. You will simply decree, and then you can talk about other things. God trusted you. That's why he brought the people to you. He thought you knew who you are. Could it be that God has entrusted people to us and we forgot who we were? So we did not speak the word. Speak the word. Messiah, speak the word. My child will be healed. Didn't the widow say so? Speak the word. No. Don't come to my child. No. Don't come to my business and fix it. No. Don't come and talk to my boss who's troubling me. No. Please, don't come to a house that keeps causing this problem and that problem. Don't come and talk to my child. Just speak the word. No. Speak the word. Your word is so strong. The fire so ferocious that it will solve the situation. Words of petition we speak. When we come to God, we often come to petition, to request, to plead with God. Can we speak that word too with command? God calls himself King of Kings. He didn't expect to be spoken of as if you were his oppressee. Oh, thank God. Who am I to come before? No. God was expecting that you speak as a king to a king so that the things, the power is so strong and the fire of it so fierce that it will bring a solution not to you, but to circumstances right around you. There are people whose prayer will solve problems next door. Hallelujah. The command so strong, the fire so fierce that it changes situations around you. Hallelujah. Your word of inspiration. When you tell somebody you are strong, you will make it. Can you say it with that belief that you are commanding situation? Your word of motivation. When you're motivating them, when you say it in such a way that it is meant to change their lives. Your word of direction. When you say, I think we should do it this way. I think we should start there. I think we should meet that. Can you believe that that word, that is what the word command means also? It's a word. Don't take it lightly. It is also meant to cause a change. Even in prayer, do not just pray as those without power. Don't pray as those who don't have what they have. But this power to command, though, depends on what we know about who we are. And that is why the Kingdom Community SA is committed to remind us who we are. Because when we do not know who we are, we will not know how to do what we need to do. Because it starts from knowing who I am. If I could wake up every day, walk down the streets of this city, and be reminding myself who I am, I have half my victory when I remember who you are, because the word says, as a man thinks in his heart, so he is. You know, that is so dangerous, because it doesn't say as you say, but it says as you think. You think, you and I don't quite watch what we think. We do often think low of who we are, and we become. Hallelujah. But it's also important that when we speak and command, we watch. The psalm that we watch earlier, he says, in the morning, he lays his request and stuff, and then he waits patiently. Another word, he says, watches to see what happens. It's very important to say what you are saying and then watch it to happen, because you are challenging God not to disappoint your looking. Not to disappoint your looking. Lord, I commanded a car. It's tough out there, dangerous. I need a car. Then watch to see how the car is going. Because often we drop a word and we forget to watch what it did. It needs to be delivered against my watching. Hallelujah. It needs to be delivered according to my watching. So my speaking is more important, but my looking is also important. It's possible for me to speak right and not look right, and not watch to see it happen. Often we fail to watch and see. The king was amazed by what he saw because he was looking. He had issued a command. Now he was looking at the command being delivered. We issue a command. When we speak to the air and say, this December, it's going to be my December. The Bible tells me that I'm surrounded by angels. That's why David says, what love is this you have for a man that you made him a little higher than angels, by the way. It doesn't say lower than angels. He says a little lower than Elohim, the God himself. So angels surround us. So when I speak, I am commanding the angels around me to go say, they are my messengers. They listen to what I'm saying, they go deliver it. They listen to what I'm saying, they go grab it. They listen to what I say, they go collect it. They listen to what I think, they go make it. They listen to what I think, they go make it. They listen to what I think, and they go make it. Amen. good or bad, and then we say the devil did this. No, I thought it, and they thought I needed it. I said it, they thought I needed it. How are you? Hey, I'm so sick. They thought you needed it. That is it. And the king, when he saw what he saw, he asked his trusted ones. The Bible calls them the advisors. Do you have an advisor? Who are your advisors? What do they see? I know what they dress. I know how the status relationship. But what do they see? My friend is the one who sees what I see or where I go. Because I need them for the journey. I don't need them for the station. I don't need my friends for a station. I also didn't need my brother, my sisters, not for the station. I have already arrived. I need nothing here. I need them for the journey. So I need to know where they are seeing and what they are doing, and I need them there. I need my wife for the journey. I need everybody around me for the journey. The Bible then says he asked the advisor to confirm whether what he was seeing is what they were seeing. There's power there. He asked, when he got amazed to see what he was seeing, he asked the neighbor what they are seeing, what he is seeing. Now, if they are not aligned with him, they will help him miss-see. If they are near him, they will help him get confused about what he was seeing. They may even help him to unsee what he was supposed to see. And therefore, a friend to me, and an advisor to me, a mentor, a mentee to me, is a potential danger if they don't see where I see. Yeah. What joins us is where we are looking at, and not where we came from. Praise God for where we came from. Praise God we suffered together with my friend. Praise God we went through the same thing together with my friend. He is my friend. And he's good. He's actually, from this point onward, my acquaintance, my friend is the one I'm working with. I don't dislike him. We grow together. We have coffee. We speak. We talk. It's fine. I appreciate what he has seen God do for us to this point. But my friend is not that one. My friend is the one who sees. The one I can ask and say, when this happens like this, what do you see? The one who can see in the spirit, not just see, you know. The one who can interpret where we are going. For me, that is my friend. The king had advisors who had to answer questions about what we are looking at and what we are seeing, not where we have been to and where we are. Is it not causing you worry that there are friends we have, we cannot ask them about a dream we had? We cannot ask them about what was dropped in our spirit. We cannot ask them about what we see ourselves doing in the next 5 years. Then I don't have friends. It's good to have seers around us, people who heard us command. The people that the king asked are the people who were sitting with the king when the king initially made a command. We need people who heard us command. We need people who heard us say in the next 5 years. We need people who heard us say next year. We need people who heard us say I am. The people who heard this, so that when we see, we say to them, is it not what I said? People will leap with us in amazement. People will praise with us in gratefulness. People who will extol with us in receipt of the things we've done. Mary had Elizabeth. Mary was pregnant. And Elizabeth was pregnant. It would have been a crisis if Mary was pregnant and Elizabeth was not pregnant. If you are pregnant with a dream, better hook in with someone who's also pregnant. So that the babies in you can leap in coordination with each other. A dangerous person is a person who does not understand your pregnancy, because they will misinterpret your pregnancy. Though you feel it and you live it, they may make you feel that there is no pregnancy. We know why. They are not right. They are not wrong. They don't have a pregnancy. So they cannot say there is a pregnancy. Ah, Jesus. Moses had a Joshua, a brother. And Moses had a sister, Miriam, the one who led him to pray all the time. Knowing that Moses is a doubting guy, the questioning guy, who even questioned God when God said, I'm going to assign you to lead these people into the next moment. You remember? He said, how come? Why me? I can't even do this, or can't do this. But Moses had a sister, Miriam. Whenever there was a word that came, the sister said, let us pray. We know nothing about Miriam except saying, let us pray. Yeah. We have people like that in our lives. Whatever happens, they always say, let us pray. Admire such people. Amen. Moses and Joshua. What did Joshua do? When Moses was fighting battles, because he was a man of practical action, very practical, Joshua was raising a hand. Was raising Moses' hand so that there would be victory in the valley. In our valleys, there are people who raise our hand so that there will be victory in the valley, so that we go through the valley of the shadow of death. We need people who can lift up our hands and keep us focused on the battle so that we can do. We say, look, Joshua, look. Look, look, Joshua. We look like we are losing. We look like we are losing. No, 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 it's your hand. How? We're winning again. Look, 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 we are winning again. We need people who are done that. Hallelujah. Let's say, look. I want to end with this. Look, I see. Look, I see. Look, I see things happening. Look, I see myself rising. Look, I see things are turning around in my life. Look, I see what is already at hand. Look, I see what I have achieved. Look, I see at what God is doing. Look, I see how awesome things are around me. Look, I see victory. Look, I see profit. Look, I see success. Look, I see movements for my good. Look, I see. The Bible teaches us that those who really follow God's ways do things that look foolish to man, but they are wise before God. Because everything a human being has not seen physically, they don't understand. But everything that a child of God sees is not yet physical. Which means that quite often, more than not, a child of God will always be foolish before an ordinary person. Because, indeed, we are speaking about something that is not there. Look at my car, but there is no car to an ordinary person. And that is why we need that patience to see truly what we see and say what we see and say it among people who can see. Because sometimes sharing that dream to people who don't understand it might confuse them even more. Go to your rural home, they don't know these things, and then you say to them, hey, I see a mention here. They would indeed think you are crazy. And indeed, in their mind, you are crazy. Why don't you say to people who also see? The king commanded among his advisors, not among strangers. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. The king he commanded. King Jesus commanded things in the midst of his 12 advisors or of people in the temple. Up to a point that people brought people and say, there is your mother and your brothers are waiting for you outside. He says, no, my mother and brothers are those who believe the same thing as me. So that when you are speaking the things of heaven, you speak with them. When he goes to talk to his family, he can talk about bread, water, and oros or something like that. So you and I must know who to sell our great ideas to, lest they might be aborted in the hands of unpregnant friends. So I see new possibilities. You can stand up. I see new possibilities in your life. I see new dreams. I see new paths in your life. I see great things happen for you.
Amen.
Now, in the book of Acts 3, verse 4, in the book of Acts 3, verse 4, we hear there of a story. Peter and John, on a certain day, go to the temple for the 3 o'clock prayer. They had a 3 o'clock prayer in the temple as Jews. As they go in there, as they approach the temple, they see a crippled man who is being brought to the temple every time. What amazes me is that this crippled man is brought to the temple to beg. Sure. Can you imagine bringing a poor person to the bank to pray? He goes to the temple of the Lord where power to heal happens. But they bring him to beg for sense. Here. They don't bring him to encounter the sense. They bring him to beg for sense and rents. Instead of bringing him there to encounter the sense of what it means to encounter God when you are crippled and receive your healing. Look, then, what does he do? He calls them, and he sees them. That's the thing. He sees them. Huh? Be careful what you see. Be careful who you see. Mind who you see and what you see. The crippled man saw them. In your journey of life, whatever your circumstance is, you will surely see something. Mind what you see. He saw them as providers of sense. Because when he saw them, he begged them for money. What he failed to realize, that they also are a provider of the sense of the divine power. So be careful what you see in others that God makes you see on your journey of life, however difficult it is. What do they do? Very interesting thing happened here. The Bible says, Peter, who was the more forward of them, says, look at us. Look at us. In another version says, look on us. That is even more powerful. Look on us. You like a beautiful dress. Look on us. You like sense about things what to do. Look on us. We have been through that.
And we now look like this.
You are sick. We were in hospital 3 years, three months ago. Look on us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. They say, perhaps what we need to do is to change what you look at. Second, who you look at. But the word look also means inspired by. I look up to someone. So look. And sometimes we need to refer someone to someone who has gone through what they went through and say, look, he was in the ICU. We are talking about the medical ward. He was in the ICU. He conquered. Look on them. Don't look at your circumstance. Don't look at your situation. Don't look at your tradition. The tradition of you, because you are maimed, going to beg every day at 3 o'clock. It's a tradition. Don't look at it for solution. Don't look at it as a way going forward. Look on us. They say. So the man gave them his attention. The man did right. That which you give attention to will change your tension. That which I give attention to will also change your direction. What happened? The man got healed. Summarize the story. The man went, according to the tradition, going to beg. The leaders they encountered changed his attitude and his attention. The outcome was that he changed his circumstance. Even today, we can come to God and look unto God as a Savior and look unto God as an author and finisher of our faith. And look unto God as the one who can give us all that we need. Address our need, address our wants. We can look unto God as the one who changes our direction, even on this day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Did you receive that, my ambassadors? Did you receive that? Look and see. Look, see. Look and see. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray right now, I say, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us all pray in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you. We give you praise, O God. We give you honor for what you have done and what you continue to do in our lives, even on this day. We thank you and we give you praise. We say, Heavenly Father, we change the direction of our looking. We change what we see. We change who we see. We change who sees with us. We thank you who sees opportunities with us. We change, oh God, everything. And we believe that by this way, you have changed us. We become better. We face the world better tomorrow. We are ready for opportunities. We are ready for possibilities. We are ready, oh God, for what you deliver to us. We are ready, mighty Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. I ask, oh God, that you will be with that person and that brother and that sister, mighty God, as they transform their lives. Will be with them, O God, as they change what they see and change who they see and change how they look. They change what they look at. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, Lord, that you'll deliver to them that which they have never seen before. You will deliver to them that which only you can deliver. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you that their lives are transformed. I thank you that their situations have changed. I thank you that they live an abundant life. As kings, as a royal priesthood, I thank you that each one of them have received a new thing in their life. They shall never, 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 never be the same again. We give you praise and we give you honor as your people prosper because you planned it so. We thank you for the word this morning. We thank you that your word is true. We thank you that your word is right. We thank you that it brings illumination. It brings understanding. It changes our attitude. It also changes our altitude. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you honor. I pray that each and everyone who heard this word may be transformed, may be changed for better. They may be, oh God, agents of change wherever they go. They will make people see what they need to see. They will cause people to change their direction of attention, oh God, and that they will receive new illumination, new, oh God, encounters a new influence in their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we thank you for your word is true in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, Sabon.
Hallelujah. We give honor and glory to the King. You may be seated. Amen. Wow. 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 Look. Wow. We praise our King. Whew, that isn't. Wow. Hallelujah. The King's command was so strong. It's true, sometimes we think of ourselves so low. But this only said something that, you know, God thought you knew who you are. That is only still ringing. It's going to ring for a long time in my head. I don't know if it will ever go. God thought you know who you are. Do you really know who you are? Do you? Because if you really knew, the Bible says, they that know their God knew his words. Amen? So, he's a good God. He's a good God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That's the presence of the King right here. Heavy, 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 heavy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you honor, Lord. In the book of Galatians, Paul is talking to the Galatians about the values and culture of the kingdom. And chapter 6, he talks to them about how we need to care each other, how we need to look at each other. He gives an instruction about how we are to engage with each other around teaching. And he says that when we are taught, we must share in our goodness with those that teach us. So let's get it over. So, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to request the host to come back. And I'm going to ask that according to Galatians 6, that we share in all goodness, we are going to take another set of investments, and all the investments that come in at this time, and they are going directly into the ministry of Babson. We want to be partners and partakers with him in the world that he created. Amen. He operates in the world of academic. We pray for that world every Consecration Tuesday. So right now we have an opportunity to partner in that world and be an influence in that world. Amen. So I'm going to ask you, young man, for a song. And while we play that song, everything that we are going to invest in right now or give, if you want me to use that word, give, it goes directly into the ministry of that is only. Amen. Amen. Let's do it.
Done so much for me, I cannot tell it all.
Now,
if I had 10,000 tongues, it still wouldn't be enough.
Now,
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. At this point, I'd just like to ask them, the Zondis, to come forward, please. Normally, when my husband would teach and be done, they will thank me instead. So I'm just coming to do. Yes. Yes, sir. Please stand on my left. As we observe the protocols of COVID, we would like to appreciate Mam Zondi for this time and opportunity to have your husband teaching to us this morning and briefing us on what the kingdom has for us this morning. This week, we are ready, kingdom ambassadors, to go and dominate the marketplace according to what the Lord has taught us this morning. The Lord says, look and see. Hallelujah. One more thing that I forgot to speak about, doctors. Yes, of course, Dr. Zondi, is that indeed he is the member in the ITWALA, the International Third World Leaders Association, which the late Dr. Myles Monroe is and was the leader of. So as we said, in the community, we're not going to bring you anything but the best. We're not just going to bring you anything that we're going to think overnight, but we're going to give you the cream of the top. He was the cream of the top today, but the next one will also be the same. So we thank God for your faithfulness. We thank God for honoring us. Thank you, Mam Zondi. We have given you the flowers, what you love. I know you always do flowers for people, and I'm not sure how many times you get for yourself. And I thought, no, you know what? Let's give them flowers. I know she's in the business of flowers, but how many times do you guys get flowers from people? So this is just honoring you this morning, and we really appreciate you. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Kingdom Community SA. Thank you to those who are watching us online and joining us this morning. We apologize for just skipping with another 10 minutes, but hey, God was here. But hey, how can we prevent the presence of the Lord? These things will happen live or no live. So let us just appreciate you, and we thank you for joining us this morning. Thank you so much that you've been here and with us. We've seen all those comments. We've seen all those likes. Join us next week. We're doing our last live service. We'll continue with our online services the whole of December to January. But we thank God for you. We appreciate you and we love you. And to all those who are here with us, where is the answer? The answer is in the mirror. To you too, the answer is the mirror. Stay blessed and stay tuned for next week. The Lord loves you. To the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we say amen. Amen.
boys and girls. Caught in self-pity, seeking self-justice. Every human come subscribe to this. Let's choose to help others, don't be self-serving. Better to give than receive, it's more rewarding. Born to lead in an area of gifting. No excuse, walk in your calling. We are the change that we want to see. We can change the world, but it takes a you and me. I am the change that I want to see. Watch me change the world, cause the change lives within me. The answer's in the mirror. The mirror. In the mirror. Oh yeah. The answer's in the mirror. The mirror. In the mirror. Oh yeah. It's not a black and white thing, but a dark and light thing. Ignorance them, highlight and knowledge them fighting. So get this right, king, you're not a peasant, you're a king. Stop fussing over dirt, which is the color of your skin. Greater than your outside is the image that's within. Your character like this, like lightning, you're shining. Don't confound, be transformed, the world changes rising. Oh, we are the change that we want to see. We can change the world, but it takes a you and me. Watch me change the world, or the change that you need. The answer's in the mirror, the mirror, in the mirror, oh yeah. The answer's in the mirror, the mirror, in the mirror, oh yeah. Heard the mirror say hello, take a look, tell me what you see. Point a finger, it comes back at me. Mirror, the mirror answers in the mirror. The mirror, in the mirror. Oh yeah, the answers in the mirror. The mirror, in the mirror. Oh yeah, we are the change, yeah. We can change the world. It takes the you and me. We are the change. We want to see it. We can change the world. It takes the you and me. We are the change. We want to see it. We can change the world. It takes the you and me. We are the change. We want to see you. We can change the world. It takes you and me.
Watch it. Jump on me, I'm a singer, I'm a singer. Now, I'm a singer. I'm a singer.